Asthma kills around 1,000 people every single day. That's 365,000 people a year, and it affects as many as 339 million people every single year. But why do people get asthma, and how is this disease deadly? Let's find out in this video. It starts with a cough or a wheeze. Soon your chest feels tight, and then you experience shortness of breath. Asthma affects the respiratory system of a person, specifically bronchi and bronchioles located inside the lungs, which carry air in and out of your body. These bronchi are like pipes having different layers. The inner lining is called mucosa, which is surrounded by smooth muscles. These linings facilitate the passage of air by maintaining a healthy space for air to move. Asthma attack occurs due to different triggers in different people. These could be smoke, dust, fragrance, exercise, stress, increased humidity, and even cold weather. When an asthma attack occurs, the smooth muscles surrounding mucosa contract. At the same time, the mucosa lining becomes swollen and the passage gets blocked, thereby making it difficult for the air to pass. It is due to this reason that a person feels breathless. When people experience such attacks, they feel that they can't inhale oxygen. But in reality, during asthma attacks, it becomes tough for people to exhale then inhale, leading to an excess of air in lungs, a phenomenon known as hyperinflation. As a result, organs within the body experience lack of oxygen, which in extreme cases can lead to death. In order to tackle asthma, the first step is to reduce the presence of triggers. But sometimes things are beyond our control because of an unpredictable environment. This is where inhalers come in. Inhalers are of two types. The one responsible for immediate relief during an attack contains medication called beta agonists. Beta agonists reach the inflamed airways and relax the tissues, causing immediate relief. The second type of inhalers contain corticosteroids, which are used to treat asthma symptoms over a long period of time. They reduce sensitivity and inflammation so that asthma can be kept under control. Although the exact cause for asthma is not yet known, it is believed that asthma might be caused due to a combination of genetic and environmental factors like pollution. In fact, a study shows that people living near polluted areas that lack medical facilities are more prone to developing asthma over time. A permanent cure for asthma is yet to be discovered, but with current medications and a healthy lifestyle, people affected with it can still live a normal and happy life. If you enjoyed this video and learned something from it, make sure you hit that subscribe button and click the bell icon so that you never miss our next episode. Got something to ask? Put them down in the comment section. We release awesome videos like this on our channel, so I'll see you guys next week. Till then, have a nice day.